morning. How's everybody doing? Oh my gosh. Good morning. How's everybody doing? There you go. That's the energy I like to hear. So, my name is Coach McDonald. Right now, you're going to call me DJ Big Sexy. Because that's how we're going to roll for today. So, what I wanted to stress to everybody, your schoolmates, classmates, friends, family members, cousins, brothers, sisters, they worked extremely hard to put this on. So I want you to cheer for them, be loud, and be proud. If someone happens to make a mistake, because I do it all the time, don't worry about it. Let them go on. Let them just continue. You know, like Sav, remember that time you threw that interception? We still love you, Sav. We still love you. Daryl, remember that time you missed those 29 tackles? We still loved you, right? People, volleyball, you missed that spike. You know, things that you do, we still love you. You couldn't hit the high note. We still loved you, okay? So I just want to make sure all that's clear. With that being said, we're going to start. Thank y'all.
All these born a slave, but glory to God, no more auction block for me. That auction block was a damn sight to see. Souls being sold by the sound of a hammer, families that God joined together were being separated forever. Blacks bartered for cash, counted as property, whipped and lashed, broken. Their black bodies broken, their spirits broken, and the only way to survive was to live with a hope in God. And even when I became free, I found life still so hard to be. They thought they was using me when they came to me and asked, but really, I was using them. I was using them in the hope to see brotherhood of all of humanity. And this should be a lesson learned, that no man should be used as property, that no man should be converted into merchandise, and that as we all bear God's image, no man should be used as instruments. Thank God for the day that freedom came. I traveled the white world preaching in Jesus' name.
Yes.
No more auction block for me. Thank you.
All right, give it up for Shadero. So we're starting our timeline in the 1920s Harlem Renaissance, a time where black people and culture were thriving and accelerating.
Coming up to the stage next, we've got Keyonche Edwards reading a poem by Langston Hughes called Let America Be America Again. Next, we'll be taking a stop in the 1940s to the 1960s, a time where our people were standing up for their rights and fighting for themselves.
Segregation on public transit in Alabama.
September 4th, 1957. The Little Rock Nine integrated into Central High School, becoming the center of the struggle to desegregate public schools in the United States, especially the South. September 9th, 1957. President Eisenhower signs the Civil Rights Act of 1957 to protect the voting rights of African Americans. August 28, 1963, the March on Washington, where MLK gave his famous I Have a Dream speech. February 21, 1965, Malcolm X is assassinated. April 4, 1968, the profound civil rights leader, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., is assassinated on the balcony of the Lorraine Motel Room in Memphis, Tennessee. Ruby. Ruby Bridges was born on September 8, 1954, in Tylertown, Mississippi. Ruby attended an all-white school in November of 1959. At the tender age of six, Ruby Bridges advanced the cause of civil rights in November 1960, when she became the first African-American student to integrate an elementary school in the South. During that time, Ruby and her mother were escorted by four federal marchers to the school every day that year. She walked past crowds screaming vicious slurs at her. She spent her first day in the principal's office due to the chaos created as angry white parents pulled their children from school. Ruby ate lunch alone and sometimes played with her teacher at recess, but she never missed a day of school that year. A lifelong activist for racial equality in 1999, Ruby established the Ruby Bridges Foundation to promote tolerance and create change through education. In 2000, she was made an honorary deputy marshal in a ceremony in Washington, D.C. Thank you, Ruby. Muhammad Ali is American sport has played champion boxer, one of the greatest sporting figures of the 20th century. An Olympic gold medalist and the first fighter to capture the heavyweight title three times, Ali's outspokenness on the issues of race, religion, and politics made him a controversial figure during his career. Many saw Ali as a draft dodger, and his popularity plummeted. Banned from boxing for 3 years, Ali spoke out against the Vietnam War on college campuses. As public attitudes turned against the war, support for Ali grew. Thank you, Muhammad Ali. The Black Power Salute photo. One of the most influential protest images of all time was captured over 50 years ago when the U.S. sprinters Tommy Smith and John Carlos stepped onto the world stage during the Summer Olympics in Mexico City. It was October 16, 1968. Smith had just won gold and Carlos had taken bronze in a blatant 200-meter dash. Australian sprinter Peter Norman, who had won silver, stood to their right. When the Star Spangled Banner began to play, Smith lowered his head and raised his right fist. Carlos raised his left. Dominique's photograph would freeze that moment of silent protest. The picture was slingshot around the world, capturing all the angst and anger of 1968. The photo will become an iconic image of the Black Power movement and an emotional reference point among NFL players who kneeled during the national anthem to protest police brutality. Thank you.
Now we'll be presenting the 1970s, a time where Black individuals truly embodied the meaning of Black happiness and being carefree. Welcome to the
In the 1980s, black artists were getting very popular with making that paper. Woke into black Hollywood.
Ladies and gentlemen, how'd you like that music? All right, well, we're gonna take it back to the Queen of Soul for you right now.